You know, people say to me, oh, isn't it depressing? And I said, no, it's completely stimulating because, you know, you see how hard they fight and you just want to work even harder because you know you can make a difference. I actually, you know, like many, many families, you know, I also have, my family has been touched by cancer. I lost my sister at the age of 27. I think maybe I was a little bit, you know, shied away from cancer research, but I think once I got involved in it, you know, it's just so compelling. And I think you see the families and the children and you can't help but want to work harder. This is a neuroblastoma tumor, and it's been transfected with a green fluorescent protein because it's easier for us to follow in animals. When we treat these tumor cells with retinoic acid, the cells stop growing and they extend processes and differentiate. Then we were able, by studying this system, to eventually translate it and with collaborators do a clinical trial that showed that patients who received retinoic acid did better than those who didn't. So now it's part of our standard therapy for high-risk neuroblastoma patients. So our latest research findings are based on when we identified that there was a receptor called TrkB that was expressed on the tumor cells, and these patients who had tumors with this receptor had a very bad prognosis. We did a study a long time ago, and we showed that if you took a tumor cell and made it progressively resistant to a kind of drug, you would get an increase in the ligand for this BDNF ligand, which is the growth factor for this receptor. And then we began to show that if you activated this pathway, the cells were less sensitive to chemotherapy. So now, the really exciting results that we have is we've identified the signaling pathway that the BDNF TrkB receptor system utilizes to block the effects of chemotherapy. And now we can take a drug that's come through the clinical trials that blocks this receptor signaling pathway. And if we block this, now the cells are more sensitive to chemotherapy. So that's really our most recent finding that we published in JNCI, and we're quite excited. It's really exciting when a basic scientist can see their, you know, work transition into the clinic and actually ultimately, you know, make a difference. And so that's why one half of my lab really works on translating these biological discoveries that we make into clinically relevant therapies for children.